What's up? This is the Political Brown Kid, and I'm gonna do another Hollywood in Black and White. I'm just kind of doing these videos before I probably decide whether I'm gonna continue this channel or not, because, like I said, nobody's paying attention, so why bother? But I'm gonna say this. In this Hollywood in Black and White, I just saw this movie. I think it came out in 2019, actually. This was a movie called Anyone But You. And basically, the premise of the story is there's this guy in the movie. It's a white guy. He meets this white female in a. So, spoiler alert. Let me just start that off right here. Let me just say spoiler alert. I'm not going to give away the whole movie, but I'm going to give away just an overview. The white guy meets white female in, I don't know what city. I think they're in Boston. They start off in Boston. He meets her there. They have this one night. Didn't even really look like they slept together. Looked like they just hung out all night together. They had this one encounter. She overheard some things that he said about her. He took offense to her, like basically bailing out because when he woke up, she was gone. So fast forward, they meet up again in a club because and it just so happens that his good friend, which is a black guy, just happens to be friends with the girl. That he, or he know, no, he's good friends with the girl's sister, and the girl's sister is marrying his sister, so they're in a lesbian relationship. So it's a black female about to marry this white female, and the black female is the black guy's sister, and the white fiance is sisters with the guy that stood the other girl up that had the encounter with the guy. I know it's confusing. I'm messing it up. But you can see the pictures here. I got the pictures of all the players. So basically, the wedding is taking place, I think, over in Australia. So they all fly to Australia and they're all staying in the same house. And this house is owned by the black guy's stepdad. And I think that his sister, which is the black female getting married, I think that that's supposed to be her biological dad. And I'm bringing this up for a reason. And so I'm going to bring this up for a reason. And the reason why I'm saying that the black man, even though the black guy is the brother to the black female, you can obviously look at them and say, one of them could be a mulatto and one of them could not, right? So you look at the black male, he looks like okay, this is a black guy. Then you look at his sister, you can see that she passes the brown paper bag test. She passes the comb test, even though she has braids in her hair. You can tell that she has a different strand of hair. So, once again, I told you all about bona fide operating qualifications. I keep telling y'all, that's the one thing I learned in school, BFOQ, bona fide operating qualifications. If you don't know what it is, go look at my videos, you'll figure it out. So I think they did that so that they could cast a light-skinned black female. But I've always noticed this in these movies. Why is it that when you look at a movie, you'll notice that a black female almost always has to be either light-skinned or have good hair. I don't make this up. They don't care what the black male looks like. The black male children, they can have, regular type of Negroid hair. Black females, they don't want to see the black females like that. They want to see you with long, stringy hair, and they want to see you caramelized complexion. I don't make this up. So the reason why I'm doing a video on this Hollywood in black and white on this movie, Anyone But You, is this. If you noticed in these clips that I've taken, and by the way, the reason why these clips look a little bit janky is because they don't allow you to film this because this is on Netflix, so you can't take screenshots or video grabs from this. So I had to do it the old-fashioned manual way. But if you look at these clips, in the very first clip, you'll see that the white guy came into the club with the black guy, and they meet up with the black female and the white female. Mind you, the black female and the black guy are brother and sister. They don't interact, not one, like, mind you, they're just meeting, they're coming into the club. You see your sister and you don't say, hey, hello, what's up? Hey, sis. Notice that the white guy speaks to the black female and the black guy speaks to the white female. I don't make this stuff up. In this whole entire movie, that black guy has maybe 5 seconds of dialogue with his sister. I don't make this up. If you think I'm lying, if you have a Netflix account, go look at this movie, Anyone But You. Go look at the movie and pay attention to the interactions between the black guy and who he interacts with in the movie. He doesn't interact with anyone. And like I told y'all before, he is the comedic relief in this movie. If you see in these other clips that I'm going to show you, like if you look in this other clip that I had in this video, you see that they're all standing on a mountaintop. Everybody's paired up. The black female's paired up with her lesbian white female. And number one, why couldn't she have a black lover? They made her, number one, they always got to plug an LGBTQ agenda into a movie. That's number one. Number two, they couldn't even, like really, they always have to interracialize everybody, every black person. They never want to see us black on black love. They gave her a white lover. That's number one. So you see her paired up with her lover. You see the white guy paired up with the white girl that he's having conflict with. So they got this sexual tension because they got this hate, love, hate relationship going throughout this whole movie. And then you see the other two white couples there. And then you see another two white couple there. And then you see the black guy with a daggone koala bear. The whole movie, that he doesn't do anything. He's just either DJing at a party, he's talking to a koala bear. He didn't even interact with his own mama. And once again, too, if you look at this movie clip, because I put the clips in here, in this movie, once again, this is why I said bona fide operating qualification. Notice that his sister is a mulatto. And look at his mother. His mother looks like she could be a mulatto. Light skin, green eyes. And once again, the hair passes the paper brown test, and she even passes the exotic eye test. I have no idea if there's an eye test, but they paired her up with a white husband. She couldn't be married to a black guy. They didn't want to give her a black husband. They always pair up black women with white men. And then black women want to know why they're running out here in these streets with all of this overt jungle fever. Just flowing through their loins, because television pushes this onto you. It pushes this onto us. It makes it so that black men, all we have is, we just have our thing in our hand, and that's what we're doing all day long. White men have all the fun. They have all of the racist chasing after them. And then black men and black women are trying their best to get them a white man. They'll do jumping jacks and sit-ups for the white man. They're not doing that for us. The only thing that they leave in black men with are the black women with attitudes, the black women with weight issues, the black women just, you know, don't have anything going, still in the hood, still want to twerk, still want to do this, still want to do that, ratchet behavior. The black women that are getting their stuff together and being cooperative and being, you know, all of these other things, being, you know, in shape and caring about their appearance and not wearing these super thick eyelashes and not wearing these super thick wigs and weaves, they're all in relationships with white men. I don't make this stuff up. I do not make this stuff up. And this is the theme of this movie. It is the underlying theme of the movie. They don't care to show us true black love. They don't care to show you with anyone. All they want to do is show you a black man. He's either castrated in a movie. Go watch Game of Thrones. Every black man is a member of the Unsullied. He doesn't have a penis. All of them are castrated. The pillars and the stones, as they would say in Game of Thrones. We're either castrated. We either don't have legs. We're either crippled. And something, we watch the movie Life. It's a movie called Life. And not the one with Eddie Murphy and Martin Lawrence. It's another movie with Ryan Reynolds when they're in space. The black man in space, everybody. Number one, how the heck do you get in space? In order to be an astronaut, you have to pass a physical regimen test. And this black man is in space and his legs are crippled. He got two skinny, the rest of his body is regular size, and he got two skinny crippled legs, and he's in space. I don't make this stuff up. But that's the short and skinny of this whole movie, Hollywood in Black and White, that I want to do for anyone but you, because once again, there's a common theme, and I just want to show that to y'all, that the black women, they're all pairing black women with white men, and the black women that they're going to cast in these movies are going to be black women that can pass the brown paper bag and the comb test. And they put in a black man in the movie as an irrelevant character who's just either asexual, or he's just comedic relief, or he's gay. That's it in a nutshell. But this is my Hollywood in black and white. I'm a political brown kid. And we'll see if I continue with this channel. I'm out.